I have two native languages, Russian and Ukrainian. I was born in Kiev and lived there for the first 24 years of my life. After that, I lived in the Turkic world, first in Azerbaijan, then in Turkey. In Azerbaijan, I worked in the Slavic University, teaching Ukrainian and compiling the Ukrainian-Azerbaijani Learner's Dictionary. This is the fruit of our work in Azerbaijan. I am a Ukrainian, so I love my language, Ukrainian language. There is a famous poem, "Любіть Україну," love Ukraine. And in this poem, there are wonderful words, "І мову її солов'їну," and her nightingale language. And nightingale here is not noun, but adjective, like nightingale-like language. You know, in Azerbaijan, nightingale or bülbül is a word that is used for beautiful voice. There is a famous singer from Karabakh, from Shusha. His surname was Bülbül. People named him Bülbül because of his beautiful voice. Interesting that in Ukraine we also had a very good singer whose surname was Solovyanenko. Solovey, like nightingale, Solovyanenko is a related word. When I call my language the nightingale language, мова солов'їна in Ukrainian, it evokes some strong emotions in my heart. In fact, this is one of the differences between the Ukrainian and Russian languages. In Russian, one term, язык, means both a part of the body, язык, tongue, and language. And in Ukrainian, we also have a word, язык, but it means only part of the body. It doesn't mean the language. For the language, we use the word мова. We also have another word for speech, мовлення. It's interesting also that мова is feminine, язык is masculine. In Russian, there is only masculine name, which is both for language and for tongue. In Ukrainian, language is feminine, мова. It almost like, it can always like associate it with a mother, our mother, наша мова, our language, наша солов'їна мова, our nightingale language. Very interesting. And in the Semitic languages also, language is in feminine. In Arabic, it's lüğa or lüğatun, and in Hebrew, it is safa. But also both languages have a word for tongue, and which is also used as language. Lisan in Arabic and Lashon in Hebrew. And you can see that those two words are also related, have the same root. Slavic languages have many different diminutive forms of words, even of verbs. For instance, a brother and sister, brat и сестра in Russian, can be братик, братец, братишка, сестричка, сестренка, сестрица. And in Ukrainian, mom and dad, mama и tato, can be мамочка, матінка, матуся, таточка, татусь, etc. And you can even use verbs, as I said, in diminutive. Like you can say їсти, їстеньки, спати, спатеньки, спатки, and all kinds of words like that. It's interesting how Slavic language can often emit verbs and the meaning can be understood just from the cases of nouns or pronouns. For instance, you can say, in English you say, he ran after her and she jumped over the fence. We can also say, in Russian for instance, он побежал, ran, побежал за ней, а она перепрыгнула через забор, and she jumped over the fence. But we can also omit the words побежал, перепрыгнула, we can just say, он за ней, она через забор, and it's more emotional when you omit words like that. Or instead of saying, what will you drink? I will drink coffee. Instead of saying, let's say in Ukrainian, що будеш пити? Буду пити каву. We can omit the word пити, and we can just say, що будеш? Буду каву. Like this. That's a very interesting trait of our Slavic languages that I also appreciate. Russian literature is very famous, there is no need to talk about it. I also love authors like Tolstoy and Dostoevsky. I love Nikolai Gogol. I am fascinated by Pushkin's poem Evgeny Onegin. It's very beautiful. And my favorite novels from Russian literature are Resurrection by Leo Tolstoy and The Brothers Karamazov by Dostoevsky. Can you believe I read all this volume? I read it in Russian, I read it in English translation as well. I really love this book. I think you will not regret if you read it. The most famous Ukrainian poets are Taras Shevchenko, Ivan Franko, Lesya Ukrainka, of course. I love their poems and I could quote a lot, but as I read Ukrainian literature, I discovered one poem by Mikhailo Staritsky that really touched some deep strings in my heart. And this poem is called Poeto, to the poet. And it ends with these lines. Співай, ридай і будь готовий. Замість лаврового терновий вінець узяти на чоло. Нехай роздавить тебе зло. Але що смерть? Хвилинна страта. А далі слава голосна. Той умирати лише зна, хто зна любити свого брата. І за таку тільки любов, співець, ти жити будеш знов. These lines are really difficult to translate into English. Especially my favorite lines. Замість лаврового терновий вінець узяти на чоло. They are hard to translate because in English there are two different words used there. The word wreath, laurel wreath, and the word crown, crown of thorns. Now, crown is used like corona. That's the Russian and Ukrainian word for crown is corona. It's used for the kings and queens. They have the crown. But Jesus didn't have the crown there. He actually had the wreath, according to Russian and Ukrainian. According to English, it is the crown. So in our languages, Jesus had the wreath of thorns, not the crown of thorns. And we have like two wreaths. And these are associated in our mind, and this makes the comparison possible. In the next chapter, I will talk about Turkic languages and what is really fascinating to me in them. And now, let's turn the page.